The St. Petersburg Metro is a rapid transit system in St. Petersburg and Leningrad Oblast, Russia. It has been open since 15 of November 1955. The system exhibits many typical Soviet designs and features, exquisite decorations and artwork making it one of the most attractive and elegant metros in the world. The network currently consists of 5 lines with a total length of 124 kilometers. It has 72 stations including 7 transfer points. Due to the city's unique geology, the St. Petersburg Metro is one of the deepest metro systems in the world and the deepest by the average depth of all the stations. The system's deepest station, Admiralteyskaya, is 86 meters below ground. Serving about 2 million passengers daily, it is also the 19th busiest metro system in the world and 4th in Europe. The subway grand opening was held on 15th of November 1955, with the first 7 stations. The 8th one, Pushkinskaya, opened a few months later, being put into public use. By the time of the USSR's collapse, the Leningrad metro comprised 54 stations and 94.2 kilometers of track. St. Petersburg's unforgiving geology has frequently hampered attempts by metro builders. The most notable case took place on the Kirovsko-Vyborskaya line. While constructing the line in the 1970s, the tunnelers entered an underground cavity of the Neva River. They managed to complete the tunnel, but in 1995 the tunnel had to be closed and a section of it between Lesna and Ploshad Muzhestva flooded. For more than 9 years, the northern segment of the line was physically cut off from the rest of the system. A new set of tunnels was built and in June 2004, normal service was restored. Line 1, also known as the Kirovsko-Vyborskaya line, is the oldest line of the metro, opened in 1955. The original stations are very beautiful and elaborately decorated, especially Avtovo and Narvskaya. The line connects 4 out of 5 St. Petersburg's main railway stations. The Moskovsko-Petrogradskaya line is the second oldest line of the metro, opened in 1961. It featured the first cross-platform transfer in the USSR. It was also the first metro line in St. Petersburg to feature a unique platform type that soon became dubbed as horizontal lift. The line cuts St. Petersburg on a north-south axis and is generally colored blue on metro maps. In 2006, as an extension was opened, it became the longest line on the system. The Nevska-Vasilostrovskaya line is a line of the metro opened in 1967. Since 1994, it has been officially designated as Line 3. It stands out among St. Petersburg metro lines for 2 reasons. Its stations are almost exclusively of horizontal lift type, and it has the longest interstation tunnels in the entire system. The line cuts St. Petersburg center on an east-west axis and then turns southeast following the left bank of the Neva River. It is generally colored green on metro maps. The Pravobrezhnaya line was opened in 1985. It is the shortest line in the system, with the stations featuring a modern design. Since 1994, it has been officially designated Line 4, but the original name is still often used in informal context. The line originally opened to provide access from the center for the new residential areas in the eastern part of the city, along the right bank of the Neva River. However, delays in the construction of the future Kruzensko-Primorskaya line, Line 5, compelled the metro officials to temporarily link the already completed northern part of the Line 5, starting from Sadovaya to Pravobrezhnaya line, as they felt that it was better to have a single connected line rather than 2 unconnected ones. From that point on, the line expanded northward as per original plans of Line 5 expansion. On 7th of March 2009, Spasskaya station was completed, creating the city's first 3-way transfer, and it officially became the new terminal for Line 4. As per the original plan, all Line 4 stations north of Dostoyevskaya were absorbed into the recently opened Kruzensko-Primorskaya line. The Kruzensko-Primorskaya line connects the city's historical center to the northwestern and southern neighborhoods. The line is planned to be expanded to the north. The line originally opened in December 2008. It contained only 2 stations until 7th of March 2009, when the Line 4, Pravobrezhnaya line, segment between Komendantsky Prospekt and Sadovaya stations became a part of the new line. The Krasnoselsko-Kalininskaya line will go from the southwest of St. Petersburg through the city center to the northeast of the city. The first stretch, which consists of 6 stations, is under construction and should be opened before 2020. The first 6 stations will be Yugozapadna, Putilovskaya, Bronevaya, Zastavskaya, Borovaya and Obvodny Canal too. It is customary to have stations in the center of a city built very deep, not only to minimize disruption, but also because of the Cold War threat, they were built to double as bomb shelters, and many old stations do feature provisions such as blast doors and air filters. The first stage is exquisitely decorated in the Stalinist architecture style, but from 1958 Nikita Khrushchev's struggle with decorative extras restricted the vivid decorations to simple aesthetic themes. During this time, a new design called horizontal lift became widespread, and 10 stations were built with this layout. The horizontal lift design is a variation of a station with platform screen doors, and has not been found elsewhere outside St. Petersburg. However, because the design became unpopular with passengers and for technical reasons, no stations featuring these designs were built between 1972 and 2018. From the mid-1970s, a new open single-vowel design was developed by local engineers and became very popular not only in St. Petersburg, but some other cities as well. Known technically as Leningradsky Odnosvod, it remains the most popular of all, and there are 60 such stations in the city. The remaining stations are located virtually on the edge of the city, and one, Devyatkina, is territorially in Leningrad Oblast, far away from the harsh underground geology that forms the Neva Delta. The six shallow Kolum stations are located in the southern and northwestern sections of the city, and the first three are found on the Kirovsko-Vyborskaya line. The first one, Avtovo, is considered to be one of the most beautiful stations in the world and was opened as part of the first stage in 1955, while the other two were built in the late 1970s as typical Moscow-style pillar trispan stations. There are two shallow Kolum stations on the Nevsko-Vasilostrovskaya line, Novokrestovska and Begovaya. Both of these stations, which use a modified version of the horizontal lift design, were opened in May 2018 as part of the line's extension in the northwestern section of the city. A sixth shallow Kolum station, Dunayskaya, opened in October 2019 as part of the Kuzensko-Primorskaya line's southern extension. The metro has a very large expansion plan for the next half century. Three new lines, Krasnoselsko-Kalininskaya, Admiraltesko Akhtinskaya and Koltsevaya, will be open. The first six stations of the Krasnoselsko-Kalininskaya line are already under construction and should be open by 2020. The Admiraltesko-Akhtinskaya line should appear before 2025. The Koltsevaya line will be open after 2025. Back in 2012, the official website of the St. Petersburg Metro claimed the opening of 54 new stations, 5 new depots and 71 kilometers of new lines. Delays due to the difficult geology of the city's underground and to the insufficient funding have cut down these plans. As of 2014, two new stations later, 270 new stations and one new depot until 2025. The rolling stock of the metro is provided by 5 depots with a total of 1,403 cars forming 188 trains. Most of the models are the Metro Wagon Mesh 81-770-714 that are very common in all ex-Soviet cities. In addition, there are older E and EM type trains on the Kirovsko-Vyborskaya line and newer 81-540-541 built by Škoda Transportation Unit Wagon Mesh on the Pravoberezhnaya and Kruzinskaya-Primorskaya line. In addition, the metro has also received 81-722 and 81-724 cars from Metro Wagon Mesh, which are custom models specifically for St. Petersburg. Approximately 14 people died and over 50 sustained injuries from an explosion on 3rd of April 2017 on a train between Senaya Ploshchad and Technologichesky Institut stations on the Line 2. Daily ridership is 2.04 million of passengers. Annual ridership is 743,007 million of passengers. Average speed of the train is 39 km per hour. Top speed is 80 km per hour. Many stations have original architectural and artistic design. 8 stations are recognized as objects of cultural heritage of Russia.